With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
So here are the Giants ready to start their initial drive of the game.
Game by his performance. I thought he played fairly well overall. The numbers won't knock your socks off. Two touchdown passes and an interception. The bottom line, though, they lost. Yeah. How does he eliminate that one interception, continue to take care of the ball, and maybe increase the number of times he puts the ball in the end zone with a receiver?
The first carry for the football. Shaken up, he's down. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. Here's a second and two now from the 33.
Discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And it's six on the pickup. That was the drive will continue. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Running back.
Last week.
Third down,
Pass it.
The Giants are going to get the football game. Oh, they'll have a tough time moving that one down. It's one thing tries to drop a pass. It's quite another to be dropping.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you and I both been to practices where we've seen, hey, third down situation, big third down alert, lock in here, fourth down play, make sure you focus just a little bit extra.
Pressure comes and down he goes. Fletcher Cox, he's been doing this for a lot of years, and another sack to his ledger there.
And that was just absolute perfect man coverage, nowhere for them to go with the football, led to a sack. That's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. He'll be taken down the back before he works it past the 50. 19 yards there in the catch. Complete this game from his tight end. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up. And they're left looking at third and eight after the second down pass play only went for two.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he gets his inside the 35-yard line. Give 18 there, the Giants have the first down.
Almost be quick bumpers above the offense right now. And bam, boom,
Biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
Looking left sideline, incomplete.
Not sure what you're thinking here, partner, but I believe the officials have done a nice job here getting together and then coming out indicating that there was a receiver in the area.
Absolutely, and he was in the area. Correct call made, no grounder. And he took the contact as he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback.
First and 10 at their own 20.
Philadelphia's offense ready to give us another look. And they're coming off a three and out in the front.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't found before. Time to shake things up a little bit and try to get this offense moving.
So how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before and realize it hasn't worked for someone else. Maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. A 7-yard gain on the play. And wants it on third down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's going to have it on his first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a gain of 16 and an Eagle first down. Here comes Sanders on the toss right. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Oh, yeah, good job, buddy. Good job.
Gain 13 yards that time. First down.
First down, Philadelphia.
Just four on the second down.
We haven't been able to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. Yeah, they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that officially a loss of one? First down line at the 34. Third down. From the gun, here's Watson. So the pass goes out of bounds, but he was not outside of the tackle box when he threw that. He's got to be careful.
You and I both know if it's even close, they're not going to give it to the quarterback. They don't want to throw that flag unnecessarily. So if you're just in the area, you're good.
And look at this. It's a fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And the Giants are going to get the football back. Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure has got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking more sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with a quarterback.
He likes to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. Give him nine there on a first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. And to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to take this close to the first down marker as he's stopped at the Eagles' 43-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there. It's good enough to move the chains. They'll look to throw here on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36.
Brings up second.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to take this close to the first down marker as he stopped at the Eagles' 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. The quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. But no gain on the play. It'll be second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
At the Eagles' 29-yard line.
Letting one go deep for the end zone. And trying to dive.
Throw now on first down. And
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Kenny Galladay, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
Brings up third down and 6 yards to go.
They'll look to throw. They'll find Galladay. That's complete. Now the Giants will use the second of their 3 timeouts. As it'll come with 36 ticks to go in half number one. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Second sack of the afternoon. He's going to wind up and air it out. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down. As we leave here at halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, we'll get you back to you and Charles in a bit, but first it's time for a trip around the NFL following an eventful opening weekend. Let's see what's happening in week 2. We'll get started up at FedEx Field in our nation's capital, and it's the Cowboys on top as they play the second quarter. Amari Cooper, a touchdown reception. From there, we head over to the Windy City. Check on the Bears at home, Soldier Field, and they were winners in that one over the visiting Arizona Cardinals. A 3-touchdown differential in the end, 35-14, the final. Finally, let's get to Indianapolis to check on the Colts at home at Lucas Oil Stadium. In that game, all tied with the visiting Patriots. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a defensive struggle. Which offense can break through in the second half? To find out, let's hand it over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. And able to get this out to the 25.
Let's go! Let's go!
At their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they'll be looking to a turn for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, your appearance can put it in practice just for that, because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that point of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult themselves on this drive. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. There's Watson to throw on 3rd down. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. Now after the punt on that play, we've got a man down in the field. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. What is the punt team now as this one sent away? 4-5 on the return, and it'll be Giant football, 1st and 10. So now the Giants set to take over on offense. They were losers last week to Carolina, but they've got the lead here as they begin this drive, 1st and 10. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Just a pile of bodies there. That's when you got to find out who's a tough guy who can stand up and make a play. It's only a 3-yard run. Sides, they had to walk away from that field like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And that will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Accepted as it moves the offense backwards. From the 14 now, they work on first and 10. Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second.
Watson, play action. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from the line. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked it on his target, but he was covered quite well. And that one's incomplete.
And he's going to have an Eagles first down by a couple of yards.
It's over, it's over, it's over.
Third down, 31. Third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. And 10. Watson. That's caught. It's John Hightower. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6. Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Watson now to throw. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Push it aside. Defense.
The hit comes late. We saw it. There's your flag.
And we know that there's a guideline, right? Ball's gone. You get one step. If you're within one step for the quarterback, you can hit him as long as it's still done legally. But anything outside of that, looks like an extra step was involved.
Give him 7 on the play, and that'll make it second down.
Second and 3 at the Giants' 47-yard line.
Now Watson. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 27-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Sanders down right around the 25. A gain of 3, second down.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up second and 7.
Operating from the gun. Watson looking left side. It's complete. He's got it. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 14. 11 yards there as they connect on the quick swing. They'll run on first down. Sanders. He takes his down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. And they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line. 5 in the secondary now for the Giants here on third. Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know it sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front. Offensive line collected victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
Elliott good with a PAT. And the lead is now 14-10.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on the kick away.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
New York ready to go again offensively. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
It's on the pickup. It's second and inches.
Second down and inches. Finds his tight end Ingram. And a 42-yard line down there. 7 yards there and a first down.
At the 42-yard line.
Here on first and 10. And 3 yards there takes him to the 45.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up 3 on that carry. No grounding call there. He had a receiver near the right sideline. It was pretty clear there. He just needed to get rid of that one.
And he did have a receiver in the area, but initially my view was obstructed, and I thought that was going to be grounding, but clearly the correct call made, and that is no call.
Is that why you threw your play sheet down? Is that why you did it? Is that the flag?
You can't be giving me up. I got a lot of issues up here in the booth. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the tree. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loved to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're told. Close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This will not fully end up. On first down, it's Sanders. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Second and 11 at the 41.
At the 41-yard line.
Operating from the gun. Watson. Oh, the ball is out. Watson lost it.
That's true.
They call that a 47-yard punt, a return of just three. And the Eagles will have him taking over first and 10.
Here we go, let's get him.
Philadelphia getting set to take the field. The defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. They start on the ground here at Sanders. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 40. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, and see if you can continue to tick it down.
Bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You take a charge.
So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. And when people celebrated, the guys who just gave up that play.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets
Get ready!
19 yards the pickup there. Move the chains. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 47. There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out on the flags.
Defense.
Trailing in the fourth this close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
Shotgun snap, and then the give to Sanders. And he'll get four there, now to about the 12-yard line.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. There's a guy carrying the ball. How about the people up front? They have leverage, athleticism. They created some nice space for him.
That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. Down to the 6-yard line. On a pickup of six as he gets halfway to the goal line.
Brings up third and the jump.
The Eagles on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. And a flag comes in as Howard falls incomplete. Let's see who this is at.
But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Elliott on for the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone.
What is this?
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped.
You ain't going to burn me!
Had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. And right now, probably just one thing in his mind, it's getting back to the hot start because he's really faded.
And ordinarily when that happens, the quarterback, as you know, is usually the leader of the squad. Now he's probably a silent camaraderie that comes about him saying, hey, guess what? We got you. Don't worry about it. Let's go, big fella. Because they know more times than not, he tends to pick things up and they tend to play well.
The throw over the middle, taken in. Get this one across the 45.
Yeah!
Dropped down. 19 yards the pickup there. Yeah! So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. You're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to 4 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo. Maybe you start coming two plays in each time you snap it off.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 37-yard line. They'll look to throw again. He'll get this one to Galladay. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 10 more there and another first down.
Stop.
got his man in stride, complete. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. And 3 yards all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down. The Eagles send off their punter now. And we think to punt, though he's faked it earlier, but he was unsuccessful. Powering his way forward. It's a 39-yard run. 3 on the return. And it'll be time for maybe one final play before we hit triple zeros. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Giants 16.
Going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Eagles, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll return home next week to take on the Kansas City Chiefs. Meanwhile,